Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of creating process, and today we're making this on the new three-dimensional logo design. And as we can see, there is a cuboid with three sides facing toward us, and we have got two texts, that's M and P, where one portion of the M is on the top and the rest are on the side and P is on the front. So to design this logo, we'll use the polygon tool to create a six-sided polygon. Then we'll use it to create these strips using the stroke option, and then we'll create this front view using the line segment tools, and with the help of shape builder we'll extract out these shapes. So let's begin the tutorial. So let's click the polygon tool and left click your mouse button here. We'll keep the sides around 6 and click OK. So we get that 6-sided polygon. Now with the shift press, just rotate with the mouse and keep this like this. So once you have get this, we'll duplicate this one more. So with the alt press, just click and drag and duplicate it once, and make sure to zoom it in, and this corner should be aligned with this corner. So just zoom it in and place it there. So once you have placed that in a proper place, just check it out whether they are coinciding on top of each other. And finally, once it's done, leave it there. Now the next thing is to create these effects. So to create that effect, before we go there, we can see that here the two corners here are rounded and here are rounded, but here it's sharp. So we'll make sure that, so we'll just select these corners and make it round. So just with the direct selection tool, just select these corners like this, 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 and this, and just click on this circular option and just click and drag, and you can see that all the corners are now rounded. Now once you have done that, we'll do the next step. So just click this and make it stroke. So we'll just go in there like this, give it stroke color, make it white, and let's increase the stroke thickness. So let's go in there, stroke, and just increase the thickness. So we can see there like that. You can just scale this up for now like this much, so we can see the exact thickness we need for the logo. So just select this and now increase the points to around, I think, 8. So let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. We can just increase it a little bit more like this. Now that's okay. Now we can see this is okay. Now duplicate this one more. So just click and drag and duplicate it and place it there. And the same way, we'll duplicate it one more here and make sure it's aligned with the cuboid or with the polygon, and just go in there and make sure it's aligned. So just click and align it like that. Now we have to ensure that the distance between each pieces should be equal, so just go in and make sure you just place it, just drag and place it there like this. This one, place it there. So once you have done that, approximate, can leave it there or just make, do a little bit of tweaking like this, just like this. Okay, so once you have done that, next thing is we'll select this, all the pieces, and with the scissor tool we'll just cut these points, one around here, one around here, in the same way, and just select this piece and delete it off. In the same way, we'll select the other one. Now with the scissor tool, just click here, one around here, and we have separated that. Just select that portion like this and delete it off. In the same way, we'll do the final, the same process with the scissor tool. Just click here and click here, and we have separated that pieces. Just select that and delete it. Now next thing is we can see here it's okay because we have to be deleting some portion here, but over here it should be finished properly. So here we'll do one stuff here. We select this B points like this one and this one, and just extend it like this. Now after that, we'll just select both of them with the selection tool and just convert them into object. So object, expand, and this will convert them into fill object. Now after that, we need a line segment to cut like this. So we'll just go in there, and with the line segment tool, we'll just draw out a line segment. We can use one from this point like this to like, should be like that. Now after that, just fill it up with certain colors so that we can see the line and after just bring it here and place it around here. So now bring this stroke around here, zoom it out and check it out where we need that. So we need the cut here around here, so we'll just make sure in the proper place like this. Now after that, select this piece and this, and with the shape builder tool, select the shape builder tool and just extract this out like this. Let's give it some fill color, like this color, and just give it some color so that we can select and delete it. Now after that, ungroup this first, this one also ungroup it, and now select this, delete this out, select this, delete it out, delete. So after that we can see we got that shape here. Now next thing is we'll just duplicate this one more. So we'll just with the alt press just click and drag and duplicate it here around here like this, give it some thickness and here and here. So we'll just make sure like this, and this one a little bit downward. Now after that, with line segment to draw out one more here. So from here with the shape press just click and drag and draw out one line here and one parallel to this. So with the from here till here, and just bring it down around here and make sure the thickness should be around this much. So we are maintaining that. So just do that like this, draw it out this much thickness. We'll duplicate this one more like this and give it some thickness here so we can get that depth. And after that, you can see we have given all that. We'll just increase, push this up a little bit, and let's extend this out a little here. So, and this one like here. And once you have done that, we'll do this, select everything with a shape builder tool. Just make this one object, fill it up with some dark color like black. Now select this, this one, and okay, that's fine. You can see that this is one object, this is okay, fine. Now after that, we'll just select this, delete this out, select this, delete this out. So we'll be deleting all that pieces. Instead of doing that, we'll just select this, 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 and just move it a little bit aside so that we can delete out the extra pieces. So just select everything, delete this out so that it's easier. Now once you have get that, we'll select this, go to object, expand this, and convert this into object form. And before that, let's just extend this little bit. So with the selection tool, just select this, and with the shape press just extend this like this so that we can get that corner finished. Now after that, select everything, and with the selection tool select everything like this, and go here, pathfinder, and subtract it. So we got that subtracted. Now after that, we need a little bit of adjustment here. So we need to need that this should be round, this should be round, and the rest it's fine. So we'll just select this corner using the direct selection tool, select this, this, select this one, and shift press select this one, and just make it round. So make sure it's round like you need, like that. So we can see that we can make it round. If it's lesser, we can just increase it like this. So we got that, but we can see that here the spacing is very less, but here it's large, so we can even reduce that. So we can just select the points here and only here and just push it up a little bit like this so that we can reduce the thickness here. So we can see that we have given that rest. We can check it out whether we have left anything here. Okay, that's fine. I think we have completed all the steps to create this. Next thing is to add the color. So we have already black color, this one. Just ungroup this one so that we can separately fill up the color. So this one is black, that's fine, but this one we need to fill it up with the color. So with art picker, that's I, and fill it up with some gray color like that. Now next thing is the final step is to add the font. So let's take the text, T for text, type out with the caps lock on my page, page, page. And the font which we are using is Ravi, so I'll just type out RAA, and we got that here. So we are using simple regular one and place it there. And after that, we can reduce the size around like around 20, and we'll go to character and let's increase the distance between each pieces. So we are giving around 800. Let's check it out. Okay, we need to give more, and we'll reduce the font size like that. and let's increase the distance between each fonts like this. So once you have given that, let's place it in the middle. So to align the text in a proper place, we'll use the ruler tool, Control R, to bring out the ruler. Now with the click and drag, we can create a ruler here, one around here, and one more from here to around here. So place it there. Now after that, we'll just make sure the text are aligned properly like this and this way. After that, just select the text, fill it up with the black color like this, and we can remove the grid by selecting and deleting it. So we can increase the font size or the logo a little bit more so that we can match it up. So you can see we have completed our logo. We have created this three-dimensional looking logo in a very few steps, which is very easy one. Instead of going to 3D and extruding bevel, which will make you confused, and it will be very difficult to create this, but using the basic shapes like polygon, we can easily create these kinds of shapes. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.